In this episode, we're talking YouTube with Karin Carr.
If you're a real estate agent or broker, this show is for you. Onion Juice is both a podcast and a movement designed to wake up and redefine the real estate industry. Here's your host, Neil Mathwick, for another stimulating episode of The Onion Juice. Let's join the movement now.
Welcome, juicers. It's that time once again for the Onion Juice Podcast. I'm your host, Neil Mathwick, and today we're talking YouTube, and I have Karin Carr standing by, and she is breaking loose. And last week on the Onion Juice Podcast, we had the juice bar. One of the questions that came in was, how do you break through on YouTube? And I said, well, you know, here's some ideas. However, I have not specifically done this. You know, I've got a YouTube channel. I've got videos out there. I'm doing things and producing content on YouTube, but I have never really broken through, so to say. And it was awesome because I saw Karin's YouTube channel posted on the Snappack group. And in there was a conversation about YouTube. And I saw she was doing some amazing things on YouTube. And I didn't know that she was also breaking through on YouTube, that she was actually getting business from YouTube. And we ended up messaging each other. And it was just a little serendipity because I was going to reach out to her, but I had a true ADD moment and ended up not reaching out to her because my phone rang. And then the next day she reached out to me and we got talking about putting this show together and talking about YouTube. So we have a packed show for you today, and I'm going to bring Karin on in a little bit. Before I do that, I want to make sure we thank our sponsors, Easy Agent Pro. You can find them at easyagentpro.com. Knightberry Title, you can find them at knightberry.com. And last but not least, Mason McDuffie Mortgage. You can find them at masonmac.com. Also want to give you a reminder to go ahead and text the word OJ Notes to 44222 if you want today's show notes. And I guarantee you're going to want them because there's going to be a lot of notes that you're going to want to take from this and links that you're going to want to check out. So again, text the word OJ Notes to 44222. All right. And now I'm going to bring Karin on. Karin, how are you today?
I'm doing great. Thank you so much for asking me to be on the show, Neil.
Oh, you bet. You bet. It's a treat to have you. And it was so, like I said earlier, it was just like serendipity to connect with you about this. And it's exciting to me because you're actually producing results using YouTube. And I think a lot of us are just like, yeah, we're going to put YouTube videos out there, but I don't know if it's ever going to work, if it's ever going to happen. So first, before we get into all that, first tell me a little bit about who Karin is and where you serve.
So I am in Savannah, Georgia, and I have been here for about a little less than a year. I've been licensed since 2005, and Northern California was where I started. But my husband and I have moved a lot, and this is now the fourth market that I'm having to start over in. And that was kind of my strategy, is I'm going to use video to try to break into this new market where I don't have any market share, I don't have any signs of the dirt, I don't have any past clients here, nobody knows who I am.
That is amazing. So you're such an inspiration for moving into four different markets, like, wow. And it's starting over every time, yet you get to carry some of the knowledge that you get along with being a realtor for so long, but starting over in every market, that's awesome. Way to go.
Yeah, I don't recommend that. If you can avoid that, I certainly would.
Right. Yes, awesome. And so you're breaking through with video. Now, tell me more about this.
Well, I started blogging 2 years ago, and I was having a lot of success with my blog. And I started making YouTube videos, mostly just to be able to embed the video on my blog to make my blog post rank higher. Because Google owns YouTube, so if you have a YouTube video embedded in your blog post, that will naturally help you appear higher in the search results. And then I started thinking, well, gosh, I can make a video in 15 minutes versus taking me a week to write a 3,000-word blog post. So maybe instead of writing a blog, I'll just make a video version of the blog. And I was doing it very sporadically. I had no schedule, no consistency. And I started getting phone calls from people that said, hey, I found you online. I've been watching all of your videos. You don't know me, but I feel like I know you. My wife and I are selling our house in New York, and we're going to move to Georgia. Will you help me? And I kind of had this epiphany where, you know, the clouds part and the angels begin to sing. And it was like, if you're getting leads like this, leads that are handed to you on a silver platter with no forethought, with no real trying, imagine how much better it would be if you actually were consistent and you had a schedule and you put some thought behind this.
Yes. Yes. And so this is my biggest takeaway right now is I think a lot of us think that we put videos on YouTube and we get 10 views or 20 views, okay? And we're not getting these huge results that others are getting. But I think that the power in all of this, and what I'm picking up right away here, is embedding it in a blog post so that it is located and found faster on Google, which that's where a lot of people are searching, right?
Correct. And I treat every video as though it is a blog post. So before I ever turn on the camera, I come up with an idea of what do I think this video should be about, and then I go do my keyword research. And I'm specifically looking for a keyword that a lot of people are searching for, but that has fairly low competition, so it will be easier for me to rank. So I do all of that research up front, and then I go record the video. And when I upload the video, I make sure that I use the keyword in the title, and I use the keyword in the description box, and I use it in the tags. And I'm being very intentional about the keyword itself, rather than I was out at a home inspection and I just whipped out my camera and my selfie stick and I did a little vlog and then I upload it to YouTube and I only have one or two sentences in the description box below. It really is just a video version of a blog post.
That's excellent. How are you doing your keyword search?
I've been using Google AdWords, but I also have a free plugin for Chrome that's called Keywords Everywhere, I think it is, or Keywords Anywhere, one of those two, Keywords Everywhere. And so if you say, okay, I think I'll do a video for first-time buyers, and it's going to be called, you know, how to buy your first house, you type in that keyword to see what is somebody actually typing in the Google search bar or the YouTube search bar. Like, what is the exact term, the phrase that they're typing in? And then I look for one that has, you know, anywhere between 100 and 1,000 searches a month is great in my view, but that has low competition. If something is getting 10,000 searches a month, that's great, but if the competition is high, you're going to show up on the 10th page of search results, which means no one's ever going to see it.
Okay, so finding that balance, right? Where it's yes. searched a lot, but not there's not a lot of competition. And so Google AdWords is a place you can do that at. And then Keyword Everywhere is another one. Okay, great. And we're planning, he doesn't know this yet, but I think I'm going to have TJ Kelly on next week because we were talking about SEO and about, well, TJ is a pro at SEO, but also YouTube SEO. And so I think this will be a great part two of this episode. So I hope TJ is available next week for me to get him on the show, but we'll geek out more about this SEO and finding the groove here. Now, I love that you're, what I mentioned last week, if I remember correctly, and if I didn't mention it, I wanted to, was the difference between searchable and social. And I think a lot of us get wrapped up into like making this into a show, right? That would engage on social. And we often forget about searchable. And I've noticed that you don't have a specific show name or it's not wrapped around a show. It's really wrapped around what people are searching for. Is that right?
That's correct. So in my mind, YouTube is not really a social platform. It is a search engine. So I am making my videos with the sole intent of being found when somebody does a search. So my videos all have the same format. I do a little short hook of, hey, this is what we're talking about today. Then I introduce myself, and then I move on to the meat of the topic of the thing. And then at the very end, I have a wrap-up with some sort of call to action. What do I want them to do? Do I want them to go to my website and download a free guide? Do I want them to like my Facebook page? You know, I'm asking them to do something. Be sure to, you know, comment down below if you have ideas, da-da-da-da. And so I'm trying to drive a lot of traffic back to my website, which has a lot of lead capture on it. But honestly, a lot of the people will either just call me, text me, or email me. They're not necessarily going to my website first. They're just contacting me directly.
That's great. And are you sharing these on social at all?
I do. I share them on my Facebook business page and on my personal page the day that I publish them. I share them on Pinterest. I share them on Google+. I share them on, you know, all the social media channels that I participate in. But that is simply to promote going to the YouTube page to watch it there. Like, I don't publish the full video on Facebook because people will watch it on Facebook. But when I decided to use YouTube, there was a real reason behind it. It was because on my personal page, everyone that I'm friends with is either another real estate agent or they are friends and family of mine, or they live in another state. So I thought, you know, I can publish it on Facebook, but am I really going to get business from it? I don't think I will, because I don't have, you know, 400 people that live in Savannah that would be watching my personal page. And with my business page, it was so brand new that, you know, because I just moved here last summer, I didn't think that was going to help me either. But I knew that on YouTube, if somebody was searching for homes for sale in Savannah, that I could rank for that. And if they were searching for how long does it take to close on a house, I could rank for that.
I love it. Are you titling your episodes or your videos based around a question, or like what is an example of how you're titling your episodes or your videos?
So yeah, they're really not episodes because it's not consecutive. It's not really vlog style at all. It's very much, it's seriously as if you took a blog post and you brought it to life in video form, in my mind anyway. That's how I'm thinking of it. So when I was doing research on one that's ranking very well is moving to Savannah. I thought, okay, people move to Savannah all the time because it is a tourist destination. We have the beach. People want to buy a second home here. Tons of people from up north relocate down here when they retire because they don't want to shovel snow anymore. So I did a video all about moving to Savannah. And that was the keyword. The keyword was moving to Savannah. So that is in the title. That is in the description. That is in the tag. I say it in the video. I mean, it's like all over that video. And I've already gotten, I think it was at 2,000 views thereabouts when I looked at it last time.
Wow. And that is all strictly coming from Google, right? Like they're searching that keyword and that video's coming up.
Pretty much, yeah. So when I look at the analytics of my videos, I can see, are they coming from, I appeared in the search results, or is it showing up on the sidebar in the related videos to what they're already watching? So you're watching a video about Savannah, but then on the sidebar is my video recommended to watch next, or it's embedded in the blog post on my website that is basically the full-length blog of the five-minute video.
That's great. That's great. And everybody could make one of those for their city.
Yes, absolutely. I mean, when I lived in Atlanta, I lived in a small town called Canton, which nobody has ever heard of, right? They've heard of, I don't know, Canton, Ohio, but nobody's really ever heard of Canton, Georgia. And I did a same blog post. I don't think I did a video about it, but I did a blog about moving to Canton. And I got a lot of leads from people that found it on LinkedIn, of all places.
Wow. Wow. And what does that video look like? Like, are you doing a bunch of takes throughout the city and filming a bunch of different areas? Or are you just...
Yeah. I kind of drove around town one day on a sunny day and took a lot of videos. Or if my husband is out driving around and it's a beautiful day, because he spends a lot of time in the car for his job, I'll say, hey, are you downtown? Take a couple pictures of River Street for me. And so I just kind of started collecting little short video clips and photos. And then I record in my home office, and it's, are you thinking of moving to Savannah? Well, I've got 10 reasons why you should. And then I'm just talking to the camera, and then I insert little, you know, photos and videos from around town. When I was talking about the job situation, how there are a lot of jobs here, I think I went to the Chamber of Commerce website and I pulled up who all the top employers in Savannah were, and I just did a screencast and I put that on top of it.
Nice.
So it's really nothing fancy. If you have basic computer knowledge, it's not really produced. It's not like I'm paying some videographer to come do this for me and make it super fancy. It's pretty informal, I would have to say. But if I spend 2 or 3 hours a week making this video, and then I start getting all kinds of leads from it, that 3 hours invested can result in, you know, $20,000 worth of commission checks.
Right, definitely, definitely. Wow. And I also noticed on your channel, I keep wanting to say page and then I don't sound hip. So on your on your YouTube channel, you post that, or you have it up in the cover that you post every Monday. Is that right?
Yes. And that was very intentional as well, because honestly, it's like having an accountability partner. If I put out there for the world to see that I'm going to post new videos every Monday, I better post new videos every Monday.
Yes. Yes. So how do you get into that routine then?
I put it on my calendar. So since I know I'm going to post on Monday, I usually record on Thursday. And I take my son to school at 9 in the morning. I drop him off. I come home and I record my video. And then I have Friday, Saturday, Sunday to do the editing and to make any graphics that want to go along with it. I just use those in Canva or PicMonkey. It's nothing fancy. And then I upload the whole shebang to YouTube, and then on Monday morning, boom, it goes live. And so I just put it right in my calendar. That is lead generation.
Yeah.
And anyone who says differently is doing it wrong.
Right.
Because
right.
It is every bit as effective, if not more so, than door knocking or cold calling, because I would argue that during those two things, you are only generating leads during the time that you're actually doing it.
Right.
Right.
Right,
but if I make
right.
a video and you find it a week from now, a month from now, a year from now, that's evergreen content that is just still out there for people to find. And so it's far more than a 3-hour investment of time.
Right. Right. I love it. I love it. And this is just the exact onion juice way, right? I mean, this is what we're all about, doing things different.
Yeah, this is the attract pillar by far.
Yes, yes. That is great. And what are you using to edit the videos?
I have a Mac, so I use iMovie because it came free with my Mac.
Sure.
I know that for PC users, there's one called DaVinci that gets great reviews, and that is also free. There are lots of different programs that you can use. And if you're somebody that just wants to edit on your phone, there are a million apps for that too. But I use iMovie.
Okay. Okay. And what's your inspiration for the content? Like, where are you getting the ideas of what the video should be about?
You know, once a month, I just sit down and I brainstorm. So I think about what questions did I get from clients. I will, I don't know, read an article in the news and go, oh, that'll make a good idea. Or I will see somebody else's video. If you see somebody doing a video in Seattle and you live in Savannah, there is absolutely no reason why you can't make a video on the same subject. You guys are not in competing markets. As long as you're not repeating verbatim what that person says, you're not stealing the idea.
Yeah. Yep. And that's the beautiful thing behind our Facebook groups, you know, Onion Juice and Snap Pack. It's like, that's where we're sharing so many ideas and can feed
right.
off of each other. That's excellent. That's excellent. And so how long have you been doing this? And do you have fear that you'll run out of content?
No, I mean, gosh, we could talk forever about real estate, right? I mean,
right.
sometimes it does get hard coming up with ideas. And that's why I try to take the time to brainstorm for the whole month. You know, all I need to come up with is 4 ideas. Surely if I sit down for half an hour, I can come up with 4 ideas. Or I will be, and they don't even have to be real estate related. I love the video that you did about the best burger contest. So
oh, yeah.
I thought, I'm going to do that about shrimp and grits here in Savannah. I don't know that I'm going to have a big contest the way that you did, just because I still don't know all that many people here.
Sure.
But I'm having a good time driving around town, eating out a lot, trying everybody's shrimp and grits to see who I like the best.
Yes, yes. Oh, that's excellent. People love to talk about food. And so
yes.
if you can get people talking about food, you're on your way. And what struggles do you have? Like, what, you know, somebody that's thinking about doing this, what's hard about it?
The editing process is by far what takes the longest time for me. So I figure it takes me 15 minutes to record a video that will end up being about 5 minutes long. So 15 minutes is nothing. And if I'm really on the ball, I will record all 4 videos for the month back to back. I record one, I run and change my shirt, I come back and I record the next one. It takes about an hour and a half start to finish. It's the editing part that takes me a long time. And sometimes you just feel like, oh my gosh, I've been sitting at this computer forever and it's not getting any better. And you know what? If you don't want to do a lot of editing, then don't. Really, all you've got to do is cut out the mistakes, and that's it. You don't have to put in a ton of graphics and the fancy stuff. Just cut out if you made a mistake and you had to start over again. Take that out. And then other than that, have a little intro at the beginning and a little outro at the end. You can order that off Fiverr for, you know, 10 bucks or so and call it a day.
And away you go, right? Oh, that's good. That's good. And what would you say to somebody that's thinking about starting this?
You will get warm leads, people that will call you. They've raised their hands and identified themselves as intending to buy or sell real estate in your market. And most of the time, they don't even interview anybody else. When I get seller leads from this and I go on the listing appointment, I say, who else are you interviewing? And they go, nobody. We just picked you. So it's a way to establish rapport with the person without your even knowing it. So by the time they contact you, they've already decided in their head that you're the one. You're the one they want to work with. So not only am I getting leads, I have closed transactions. I have 2 buyers in contract right now that all came from my YouTube channel. And I've only been doing this consistently since June of last year.
That's amazing. So let's talk about the results, and which is usually something that we don't talk too much about on here because a lot of it is long game and it takes time, but you're getting results since June of last year. How many have you closed?
I think I have closed 3 and I have 2 in contract and I have 4 buyers that I am actively working with and I have a coming soon listing.
Wow. So that's 3. I missed those numbers again. You got 10 deals?
3 closed, 2 pending, and then a bunch of other ones that are, you know, currently working in future business.
So 10.
And that is for a grand total of probably $100 out of pocket because YouTube is free. All I had to do was buy a couple of lights and a microphone and the little intro that I bought off Fiverr.
Yep.
That's about it.
That's awesome. That is awesome. Since June, not even 1 year and getting the results. So that's just awesome. That's just awesome. Well, I've got one more question for you. You mentioned earlier that you're working on a class around this or a course around this. Is that true?
Yeah. So because I do share it on Facebook when it first goes out, a lot of my real estate agent friends are seeing it and then they've subscribed to my channel and then they start emailing me questions or sending me Facebook messages. And I spend a lot of time answering questions for all of these people and thought, you know what, I ought to just make an online course. And that way people can get all of this information. And because when I start telling them what I do, sometimes I feel like it's information overload and their head's going to explode. But if it were in a course format where they could just do, you know, 5 or 10 minutes at a time, it might be easier to digest. So I started working on an online course. I am not even close to having it finished yet, but I just put it out there a couple weeks ago on YouTube and said, if you would be interested in taking a course, sign up and let me know so I can see if there's any interest in this. And I've already had about 50 people sign up. So if you want to be put on that list, when I release the course, I'll just send you an email letting you know that it's available. Just go to youtubeforagents.com and put yourself on my mailing list.
Awesome. That's again, youtubeforagents.com. I didn't know you already had a mailing list going. This is great. I thought this was like...
Yeah, I just started it to say, okay, I've had this conversation about 17 times in the last 4 days. Maybe I should just do an online course.
Yeah. Oh, that's great. That is great. Well, you've got a great thing going and you're an inspiration to me and to many others. I've got a page full of notes here of things that I'm going to be doing with my channel. So I'm excited to implement all of that. So thank you so much, Karin, for being on the show.
My pleasure. Thank you so much for having me. It was really fun.
Awesome. Awesome. And again, you guys can get the show notes to today's episode. Just text the word OJ Notes to 44222. Again, text the word OJ Notes to 44222. Again, thank you, Karin. I appreciate you.
Thank you so much, Neil.
Awesome. Thank you for listening to the Onion Juice Podcast. I hope you have a great day. And like always, remember to be the reason somebody smiles today.